Everybody was asking me this morning about the Hang Seng, and that was what I sort of boned up on.
Wait a minute. Don't make fun of us. You don't have to be here.
Yeah. We brought you here to sex us up, Mike.
But you know what I mean? There's a lot of oxygen being sucked out of the air with this. And I think rightly so. Do you know, have you heard anecdotally, is the president just beside himself at this point?
That's just it. And that's why it matters that it's consuming the president, that this is on his mind when he has these momentous other crises going on. So what we're told is that James Comey, he may tweet about it and they may obsess about it on the outside. But that's a sideshow. What they're concerned about are the two ends of the investigation. You could call it now a cell investigation, because down here you have Bob Mueller, the special counsel. Up in New York, you have the feds going after the lawyer, Michael Cohen, providing, as you said, the New York Post would today, Cirque de Stormy.
So I guess, given that some of the Michael Cohen stuff relates to a visit to Prague, which would indicate collusion, but a lot of this, or at least that's what, you know, that's what's behind all the thinking there. I don't know whether there's anything to it or not. He denies that he was in Prague. But other than that, what if it's an illegal real estate transaction that is found in Michael Cohen's files from 2005? I mean, I know it was a lie that Bill Clinton told that got him impeached. It had nothing to do with Whitewater, but is that something that could present a problem here, something illegal that happened in the Trump business world years ago? It didn't seem like that was Mueller's, that wasn't the objective of this whole special counsel.
You're right about that. And this makes you wonder, is Mueller starting to go for a volume play? Is he trying to stack up so many different political...
What, just to get rid of the guy? Just because that's his end goal, get rid of this guy? Is he a partisan guy that wants Trump out? Why is his goal to get, you know, to kill you with 1,000 cuts of things that don't relate to Russia? I don't get it.
Yeah. Well, as you know, he's not a partisan guy, and this is a kind of a contrast to how Comey is presenting himself. James Comey out there, and in addition to Tax Day, this is also Comey Day, finally the actual publication. But he has this great flair for the dramatic. Mueller, very much more just the facts. But the facts are adding up.
Although Mueller himself has said a lot of what's been reported in the media has been wrong.
That I was mentioning. I think he was relating to a recent story that said that Michael Cohen was in Prague. And I think that was the scuttlebutt, was that maybe don't believe everything you're reading.
No, and time and again with the Mueller findings, we found we don't know anything. But the other sign in those Mueller filings is there's always more. It's always been bigger than we thought. He's always been more aggressive than we thought. So the Mueller reports, and now we're hearing that they could be sequential, more than one. Like, that is going to be the reading of our time, because it brings together questions about the election. It brings together, like, how this government is run now. And the other person that brings all those together, and people close to the president say this may be why he's in such a sour, foul, stormy mood, is
really Michael
Cohen brings together the personal side, the finances, the business, the politics, the family. So for 10 years, he's kind of been a Rosetta Stone to what's inside Trump. And here's what's driving them crazy in the White House. They don't know what he has. They don't trust him to tell them. And so the president has no idea what might be coming. We know that Michael Cohen made tapes. We know that
tapes, that itself is weird, right? Like, the idea that you could make tapes without the other party even knowing what you have.
Well, and the...
That you're taping them?
Yeah, and of course, the president, as you know, the president used to tell people he was taping or threaten tapes. A lot of times those turned out to be just something that he was saying. But it's something that, in that world, they were very comfortable in talking about.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.